Both teams won here at Villa Park on their last FA Cup semi-final appearances. As Clive Hunt turns well. Driving in a shot. Oh, Clive lost it. Hodge got there. He scored. Left that it's gone. Clive couldn't hold it. The shot from Clive Allen and Hodge, back on his old ground, the former Aston Villa man, has given Tottenham the lead. Jubilation among the Tottenham fans. The shot driven in by Allen, it squirmed away from Plumlee, who couldn't hold on. And how quick Hodge was then to spot the opportunity. Got in before Bardsley and just steered it under the body of Gary Plumlee. There's the master sniper, and Hodge, the first to react. So Watford, a goal down, than they were to Arsenal in the last round, remember? Well, Gary Plumlee beaten off for only 11 minutes. But he wasn't lacking in confidence when I spoke to him yesterday, and I'm sure he won't be now. He's a very confident fellow. Clive Allen. Shouldn't have been any problem at all. Off McClellan, bluntly committed, and it's 2-0. 13 minutes gone. Well, what misfortune for Gary Plumlee and Watford. The Tottenham fans absolutely ecstatic.
Hodge will take.
Paul Allen. Still Allen going all the way. Half-time. Paul Allen has surely now put this semi-final beyond Watford's reach. A shot sneaked in. And Paul Allen had the commitment and had the pace to go on. Plumlee seemed to have it covered, but there was a gap at the near post. Paul Allen has scored, only his second goal of the season. And the left foot drive beyond the hands of Gary Plumlee. And it's 3-0 to Tottenham. It's Hodge, controlled it well. Now Waddle. Ardiles. Hodge with a shot. Lovely beat. 73 minutes gone. And Tottenham now in complete command. And well, they might celebrate. Steve Hodge. And didn't he finish it well? Back at the ground where he didn't really have too many happy memories with Aston Villa. But my word, he'll have some from today. Beautifully struck. And Plumlee nowhere near. The ball flew past him. Well, there it is, 4-0. Malcolm Allen. And the header is in from Allen. Well, it's no more than a consolation, surely. But it's been warmly applauded around the ground by the Watford fans. 15 minutes from the end. Malcolm Allen, one of Watford's two substitutes. He still have a memory. Good headed out too, up beyond Clements. Free kick floated in by Porter. And Allen, a strong headed out. Too late, surely. 4-1. Well, you can't say it's been an epic semi-final. It's been rather one-sided in terms of goals, anyway. Tottenham are back at Wembley. The disappointment of a League Cup semi-final defeat against Arsenal forgotten now as the Tottenham players celebrate. Steve Hodge, scorer of two of the goals. Clive Allen with the deflected shot off McClellan, and Paul Allen with the others, and Malcolm Allen getting his name on the score sheet for Watford. It was all too late by that. You can't help wondering what might have happened if Tony Cope and Watford's first choice had been in goal. As it was Gary Plumley, the man from non-league football, who came in today. Four goals past him. Chris Waddle is going to Wembley. Can't believe it all. There were scenes of wild jubilation among the Tottenham fans. But David Cleek too, their manager. Third time lucky for him after being a loser in two previous semi-finals as a manager. Glenn Hoddle, who was there in 82, on the last occasion. The scoreline says it all. It's Tottenham 4, Watford 1, and it's Tottenham who are back at Wembley.